Golf Channel, and the LPGA Tour proudly present the race to the CME Globe. From Galloway, New Jersey, it's final round coverage of the ShopRite LPGA Classic presented by Acer. It has just been an absolutely glorious first weekend in October. With the stately Seaview Resort and the Bay Course in the shadow of Atlantic City. Is someone's ship going to come in this week for the first time? The Bay Course, having hosted the world's best in women's golf since 1986, Atlantic City has been such a good site for women's golf, U.S. Women's Opens in decades past, and someone's going to hoist that trophy come days in. Will it be someone for the first time? Grant Boone and Paige McKenzie. Here's the overnight leader, Mel Reid. Her second shot at the par 5 third.
Yeah, she's really been able to take advantage of this hole so far this week, hitting driver off the deck one of the days, reaching the green yesterday and making eagle in another beautiful approach shot there, hitting the green in two.
She's now 9 under through 10 par 5s this week after a two-putt birdie. Jennifer Song, the American, with her second at the fourth.
Yeah, and greens are still receptive. Of course, hasn't received any rain since Tuesday, but you can see just how quickly the ball is able to sit on the greens.
That would take her to 16 under par, one behind Reid, but Reid, her third at the sixth.
Yeah, difficult lie there. Didn't get as clean a contact as she wanted and got a little help from off of the hill, but not enough for Mel Reid.
She would go on to make bogey and drop back to 16 under, tied with Song. The other member of that final group is Jennifer Kupcho, the 23-year-old American, the amateur sensation, trying to win for the first time on the LPGA Tour. A nice par save after missing the green at 6. On the tee at the par 3 7th, a two-way tie, Reid and Song. Song is already gone and come up a bit short. This is Kupcho. Reid still to come.
Three of these par threes really difficult. This being one of them. Doesn't go. Yeah, that's going to be a tendency for a lot of the players today. Green starting to firm out a little bit.
Paige and I are joined today by Tom Abbott, and on the course, Jerry Foltz and Karen Stupples. Temperatures just shy of 70. And Tom, we send it over to you.
That hole tucked all the way in the back left, Jerry, and it's a pretty long way today, 200 yards, but helped by the wind still?
Yeah, strongest and most sustained wind of the week and straight downwind here. That hole's actually accessible because you got a bank left of it that you can ride down right next to the hole. I've seen it a couple of times. This line is good if it's the right club.
Not quite. Took a soft bounce. I've seen a few of those this week. Obviously, didn't want to go too far past. Erring on the side of caution now, she's going to have a tough putt. So, well, we have a moment. Let's go up to Grant.
Tom, thank you very much. It's the week before a major championship. The KPMG Women's PGA Championship is about 80 miles from here next week at Aronimink near Philadelphia. But today, something very significant could happen to one of these players in the final group, or perhaps someone from back in the pack making a late run. Winning on the LPGA Tour, it's not easy, as Mel Reid has discovered in her career, having won multiple times on the Ladies European Tour, having appeared in the Solheim Cup for Europe three different times. You see how she's done here since the restart. The tie for 7th at the A&A Inspiration. The tie for 5th at the Cambia Portland Classic 2 weeks ago when she took the lead into the final round, shot 74, finished in a tie for 5th. Golf is an individual sport, but for Mel Reid, these days, it's all about the team effort.
I think that it's just a complete shift in mindset, if I'm completely honest. You know, I feel like I'm very happy with my team. I'm very happy with the way that that's kind of, you know, molded together nicely. I feel like everyone's getting on, like, not just getting on, but everyone's on the same page. And I just feel like, you know, pretty valued in the team that I'm in. So, yeah, I mean, it's obviously great. I kind of knew it was always in me to do this. I wasn't quite sure how to get there. It's just took me a lot more years than I expected to, but I'm just glad to be here, and it's just, yeah, it's a fun experience. Like, we had a lot of fun today, me and Dez. Like, it's just nice to be in this position.
Dez is her caddy, Ryan DeVoe, and Ryan said one of the things that attracted him to Mel Reid when he was deciding whose bag he was going to take, he had several offers. He said he loved her fight. Page.
Yeah, and she's actually known for that. If you even go all the way back to 2016, Mel Reid ended up playing as an individual during the International Crown. Her partner, Charlie Hull, was not able to compete against Team Japan, and she was able to take them all the way to the 18th hole in best ball when she was playing with her own ball. So yeah, she's got a lot of fight, and she's proven it before.
Well, with her bogey to drop back to 16 under, does that open the door? Nine?
This is Georgia Hall for back-to-back birdies to end the front nine. It's been a really good spell for Georgia Hall, having won in Portland a couple of weeks ago. Got her first victory on U.S. soil, having won the AIG Women's Open at Royal Lytham. This is at the seventh, and Jennifer Song with a tough one here.
Yeah, horrible tee shot to leave it here. Severe uphill lie, which is great on a short bunker shot, but not on a 25-yarder. That is
well
ridiculous.
Class. Well, class. Tap in par. Move on.
That was so good, especially with so much sand. It's a little bit easier on an uphill slope to be able to clip it if it's a little firmer and compact sand, but you could just see, based on her right foot, you can see how much sand is in there. Able to judge with her shoulder angle, kind of hitting almost up on the upslope. You can see the loft. Didn't try to fight the upslope, was able to hit with it, and man, was that a good shot.
So much can go wrong there.
That's the best shot I've seen in quite some time right there. I'd like to be able to tell the viewer at home how to do it, and I have no clue.
And the way they've raked the bunkers this week, there are some deeper grooves with the rakes, so the lies in the bunkers aren't always as good as you would expect. So that was fantastic from Jennifer Song, as she's bidding to win, of course, for the first time. Now Mel Reid taking a look at this long putt, basically the whole length of the green, Jerry.
It is, yeah. What was it, back 26 steps? She might be on one step, so 75-footer uphill the first probably third to a half, downhill the last little bit. And a bit of a double breaker, turning right early, and then there is a point two-thirds of the way there, it starts coming left.
It's a little bit tricky when you've got these uphill to downhill, and there's few places on this golf course. I find it very unusual. Not a lot of golf courses you end up with a mound where you'd be going, you know, walking uphill in snow both directions, and then downhill on the way back. It's very similar to this putt. She's going to have a real test on speed on this.
Anything inside 5 feet will be satisfactory. Closer than that, just a bonus.
Good effort there. Very good. So you got the speed down from long range. It's certainly going to be a fascinating final day for these three players in this final group. Most likely the winner will come from the final group, but you can't go to sleep on someone like Nasa Hataoka, who's creeping up behind them. And now Kupcho, fortunate to not go too much further here.
No, yeah, this is really the only choice for this shot is to putt it. You could chip it along the ground, but that'd be the only other one. More fringe than green. Not a lot of slope either way, uphill or downhill.
Good putt there from Kupcho. Been struggling with some back pain this week, Jennifer Kupcho, upper back pain. She said that she had a rib out earlier in the week, sought treatment for that, and she thinks that some of the inflammation from the rib problem has led to back trouble, so much so that she was on the brink of not being able to play. She was in that much pain yesterday, but obviously battled through it and played very well. But Jennifer in a bit of discomfort during the week here in New Jersey. And now Mel Reid needs to take care of business here, having dropped a shot on the previous hole.
Yeah, these are huge.
Oh. Well, today it's always going to have some ups and downs, but this the low point so far for Mel Reid for the week. Back-to-back bogeys, and she falls one back of Jennifer Song, denied by the lip there. Head scratcher for Reid. Final round of the ShopRite LPGA Classic.
Volunteers are the lifeblood of every LPGA Tour event. The AXA LPGA Volunteer Service Award is created to honor a deserving volunteer at each tournament during the season. Someone who exemplifies the spirit of volunteerism and goes above and beyond expectations in their role. Meet our latest honoree.
This is for every girl who won't give up on her dreams. This is for every girl who's faced heartbreak, hardship, or illness and doesn't back down. For every girl who believes that on any given week, it can happen for her. And who embraces the moment when belief and opportunity come together and her dreams come true.
I almost quit playing last year, so thank God I didn't.
I'm Sophia Popov, and I drive on.
Good afternoon, golf fans, and welcome to the 28th year of the ShopRite LPGA Classic. Although we will miss having fans at the event this year, one thing that will not change is our commitment to charitable giving. Since partnering with the LPGA Tour, ShopRite has donated nearly $35 million to local worthy causes. And we are proud to continue our commitment to those in need this year and beyond. We look forward to seeing you at our championship in 2021 and at your next visit to your local ShopRite.
It's an amazing amount of money that's been raised by this tournament over the years. I think it's going to be over $36 million by the end of this week. Henderson with her second to the ninth.
Yeah, one of those reachable par fives. Really, really nicely played there. It's not going to be a very accessible hole location coming in with the long club. You're going to see a lot of players kind of ball do exactly that. Now it's got a pretty steep uphill putt right back at it.
This is Kelly Tan at the 8th, and Karen Stubbles is there.
And this is from 81 yards. She very sensibly hit driver off the tee to get it to the widest part and didn't have to take any issue with the reeds around here.
So Kelly Tan will have that to bounce back and get to 12 under. And so that final group is waiting to tee off. And let's meet them in their own words. Our featured group is presented by Eurofins, safer at work.
Hi, I'm Jennifer Song. I'm from Ann Arbor, Michigan. And one thing you don't know about me, I'm a serious ice cream connoisseur.
I'm Jennifer Kupcho, and I always have to have my nails painted for tournaments.
Hi, I'm Mel Reid. I'm from Derby, England, and I'm a tattoo fanatic. I've got about 7. I'm going to get a lot more, so watch this space.
Featured group presented by Eurofins, safer at work. There they are, all three looking for a first victory. Perhaps comparing nail polish colors and tattoo ideas. Okay, Nasa Hataoka, we can see the red line, Karen, so she was in that penalty area?
She was, and she hit a 3-wood off the tee. I mean, she's trying to play it into position, but in order to get past all the trouble, you have to hit it at least 217 yards, and it's into a howling breeze right now, and, you know, even as strong as NASA is, that's a little bit out of her range. And she flared it a bit out to the right and just didn't carry all those reeds. There was a bit of a search party, some brave, intrepid volunteers disappeared off into those reeds to see if they could find anything, and nothing was found. But
have they come back?
Fortunately, yes.
Okay. But without her golf ball. So
yes.
Here we go, third.
But they did get a good spot on where it went in, which is where she is now. Ooh, and you could see the wind hold that ball up in the air as it was coming down.
Back-to-back birdies for Nasa, and she'll hustle up to the green to look at her putt for par. We'll try to stay two back of this woman, Jennifer Song, 210th career LPGA start, Jerry.
Yeah, and showed a lot of form just, what, 2 months ago, if it were, at the Scottish and Women's Open Championship, AIG Women's Open, 2 7th-place finishes, her best 2 of the year. But when we watched her play there, I was getting texts from friends, Paige, they're like, where has she been? And
right.
Why is she not here every week? Because it looks so impressive.
It's very understated. There's just a lot of fairways and greens, not a lot of mistakes.
And she's listening to Karen's advice. That looks like driver. Or is it not?
It's driver.
Yeah, that's a smart play. Widest part of the fairway is the farthest part of the fairway, but this one's headed a little right, and it's right on the edge of the swamp.
But that's why Karen was saying driver so important. She is up and in play. Three wood would have been in that penalty area.
Saw a few groups go through here, including the penultimate group in front. Every single group has had at least one search party going on, either right or left. You got really high reads, potential lost ball left, and then, of course, the Field of Dreams area over on the right.
Now, Kupcho.
Three wood for Jennifer. Oh.
That looked like a Field of Dreams opposite field double.
Just a little low and heely.
She's okay. She's up. Looked like it sat down, though, didn't it? Maybe?
Oh, yeah, it's up. It's in that first cut of rough.
Now Reed with a driver.
Yes, I like this play. And it also keeps it out of the wind better too, Paige, because it's just not going to have as much spin on. That's a good one.
Well, and she's been hitting her driver so well all week, and really coming off of 2 bogeys, it feels good to kind of stand up there with a driver, feel like you're in control again. So maybe she can kind of flip the switch on this little bogey train she's on. We've seen this swing over the last couple of days. Not a lot of hip turn, wide arc, very late hand set, and then really smooth transition where she's got almost a squat down as she creates some power with her lower body. Really, really pretty golf swing.
To the ninth.
We were out there earlier, weren't we, Paige? Just a slow putt.
Yeah, it's almost deceptively slow because there's not only a ridge. Whew. Good speed there. Almost a ridge, but also from back to front, the entire part of the green slopes that way.
It's time for our course setup. It's brought to you by the Golf Course Superintendents Association of America, the Bay Course at Seaview.
Yeah, beautiful golf course and very much in front of the players. We've seen the wind become the real defense on this golf course. Jerry mentioned it. It's the highest amount of wind that we've seen so far this week. So that's going to be the biggest challenge, I think, for these players moving forward, as we've seen the greens maybe get a little bit bumpy in the afternoon as well.
Hataoka for par.
And this to try and keep some of her momentum going. She had a string of 3 birdies.
Yeah. How about this? That feels like a birdie, doesn't it? Into
Definitely.
The penalty area off the tee and saves par. She is just 2 shots back with a reachable par 5 coming up. That one, in fact.
Henderson just tapping in the birdie at the ninth, so that takes her to 11 under par. 1 under on the front nine, couple of bogeys, and then the 3 birdies for Brooke. Not out of it.
All right. In pink, 10 for birdie at 8.
And she's been having a nice little year so far. Had a 9th-place finish at Marathon and an 11th place.
Didn't like that right off the face.
You just know, don't you, Paige?
Yeah, and it's so frustrating when you know it's your error. It's not that you misread it or that the ball bumped or you just got unlucky. It's one of the things you can control, and that's putting a good stroke on it. So certainly a missed opportunity for Kelly.
You look at the last 4 groups, and all 4 of them have at least 2 players who've yet to win on the LPGA Tour, including the overnight leader Mel Reid. It's time for Consumer Cellular's Worth Talking About. And how about this final group? Mel Reid, a career best 74th in the world rankings after the tie for 5th, and at Portland, the tie for 7th the week before the ANA. Jennifer Kupcho, it's just her second year on the LPGA Tour, and she only had half a year last year because she deferred her membership until after she finished college, and she's only had, again, about half a year this year. Did have the second place at the Evian Championship. And then Jennifer Song, her best finish, that playoff runner-up finish to Pernilla Lindberg and NB Park at the ANA Inspiration. 210th career event for Jennifer Song.
I think you have to hit it really good to get up there.
This is Kupcho after that unintentional stinger off the tee.
I like that one more. Yeah. Then you don't have to swing as hard.
One
110. Yeah. 110 shot, perfect. Okay.
103 yards actual, adjusting it to 110 for the wind, ending from the right. And they did not discuss at all any potential for this to jump. It looked like a pretty decent lie.
There's the defense you're talking about.
Yeah, and the one thing that you kind of heard her caddy say, is that you don't have to swing quite as hard, which into the wind is a good thing as far as controlling the spin.
That needs to go a lot.
Will the bunker shot be any easier going into the wind?
Oh, well, certainly easier going into the wind. It's just going to be a tough bunker shot. Not a lot of green between the top edge of that bunker and where the hole location is.
Song took driver, flirted with that red line, but now her second.
And is so fortunate to have done that, because otherwise it's fighting for a par the way NASA did. That was a very clean lie. Plenty of club. Smart play. That front hole location with the blustery wind, nah.
It just tempts you, though, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Look, it's a perfect little picture, but safety is behind the hole location.
Now Mel Reid.
It's a good golf swing.
Quality shot there.
Well, it's just smooth, too. Mm-hmm. You know, the tendency, obviously, when you're nervous is to speed up, but it's also the tendency when it's windy is to speed up the tempo, and that was just really nice and smooth.
So Jennifer Song leads it by one. Birdie's coming up. Today's coverage is brought to you by ShopRite, helping you get it together together. Volunteers of America, helping America's most vulnerable. And by CME Group, how the world advances. Third shot just a moment ago for Jennifer Kupcho at 8.
Very much short sighted from here. Got to get cute to get it close.
Oh.
Ooh, that's not a good sound.
Not cute.
Yeah, that's usually where you're going to see a player have that kind of long, languid swing. That was just a little bit short and choppy. Just didn't have the patience in that kind of swing.
Kupcho, for just a brief moment, had a share of the lead until Mel Reid topped her birdie with one of her own at the third. Now she's in danger of giving at least one back. Her fourth at the par four, eighth. Her scrambling and sand save numbers have not been good in her couple of seasons out here. Now Song for birdie.
Breaking left, flat putt speed wise. Rolling nicely.
Stress free.
Looks like she's in pretty good control of her emotions at this point, Paige.
Yeah, it's actually surprising that we haven't seen her walk into the winner's circle yet based on kind of her amateur career coming out here. I think she'd probably say she's underachieved. She finished 13th in the U.S. Open as an amateur. She won the Pub Links, was runner-up at the Pub Links the year before, won the U.S. Amateur. She's a highly, highly decorated amateur career and just hasn't quite cracked the code yet in her professional career out here.
220th career start. I think I shorted her 10 when she was coming up the fairway there. Now Mel Reid has a chance to join her at 16 under.
Good leave here, too, up to the slope. A little bit of slope coming off that front right bunker could push this right early. Not much.
About it.
Wow.
Walks it in. She answers the back-to-back bogeys with a birdie at 8, and she's tied again for the lead.
That's just huge for momentum. To be able to not only steady the ship, but to be able to get one back right away.
At the 10th, Brittany Altomare.
10th hole's a short par 4. Wedge in hand should be a green light. We'll get a little bit back. A little bit more.
Oh, maybe a red light. Back it up.
Really nice.
And a bogey putt at the 8th for Jennifer Kupcho.
Yeah, showed a little frustration 2 holes ago with a bad approach shot, and really he didn't find the club face the entire hole here. This would be a huge escape if she were able to make this left rider.
I thought she had
it. That's a good roll. A little firm.
Well, she's not in yet, so she's going to drop at least 2, and she's going to be 3 behind her other players in that final group. At the 10th, Henderson. Paige, we've seen a 28 on the back 9 from Altomare this week. We saw a 29 on the back 9 from Maria Fassi, so maybe Brooke Henderson make a run. All right. Song taps in. I think Kupcho would have been in her line had she gone first.
But to your point, Grant, whether it's a chaser in the back or whether it's just going to be a mix of the leaderboard at the top, there's a ton of opportunity as you make the turn on this golf course. A really big chance to either provide some separation or to provide some volatility.
Double bogey 6 for Jennifer Kupcho. And the great start has been erased.
Every day, players are going to have to overcome adversity, and this could be just her moment.
Second at the 9th for NASA.
Well, as Paige was saying about great chances, this 9th hole is one of them. Straight downwind, this from 185 and a 6-iron.
Just needs to hop, take too many hops. The green slopes severely from front right to back left, so the ball just keeps feeding that way. It's going to be a quick putt for NASA, but it is an eagle putt.
Next week, the best in women's golf head to Aronimink, about 80 miles from here in the Philadelphia area, for the KPMG Women's PGA Championship, October 8th through 11th on Golf Channel and NBC. A lot of players got a sneak peek of Aronimink last week. Brooke Henderson will be a returning champion at that KPMG Women's PGA, the winner in a playoff over Lydia Ko in 2016. Look where she's aiming here. High enough?
She was waiting for it to come back the other direction.
To the 9th.
Great opportunity here for Mel Reid on the tee at the par 5.
Like that one instantly. A little bit of breeze, actually quite a bit of breeze, helping, really making this hole easy today.
Just looks so comfortable with the driver and so controlled that golf swing.
It's a second shot golf course. Once you get the ball in the fairway, it's about placement, and it's really about placement off the tee, even based on where these hole locations are, because the greens are relatively small. So if you've got the confidence to step up and hit driver, it's a lot. It goes a long way, I guess, in providing confidence on the hole.
Jennifer Song should be hitting next. I think she may have taken a bathroom break, or a loo break, as we would say in England. So Kupcho is going to go.
Yep. Needs to just hit a good shot right now. One at a time. Yeah, excellent start right there. She has plenty of power in that swing.
Yeah, knocking it past Mel Reid by quite some margin. So Jennifer Kupcho can really move it out there when she needs to. Here's Jennifer.
Maybe she went for ice cream. She did say she's a connoisseur.
Well, and so are you, Grant. Don't cut yourself short. Actually, Tom, I'm not sure which one is a bigger fan of the ice cream.
It's my weakness. We did find a fantastic ice cream parlor just down the road from here last night. Jennifer Song, 30 years of age, 10th year on the LPGA Tour. Best finish. That playoff loss at the ANA Inspiration, of course, was won by Pernilla Lindberg. Everybody remembers it for Pernilla Lindberg and Imbie Park, but Jennifer Song did start out in that playoff. US Women's Amateur and US Women's Pub Links in 2009 before turning pro, going onto the Symetra Tour and quickly gaining her card for the LPGA. She's ready to play now.
Doesn't have quite the power as the two fellow competitors, but she can get there in two of the stays in the fairway.
No. I find the longer rough, not the really thick stuff, but might be able to control it like she would have liked there for her second. May still be able to get one running up onto the green with the down breeze. We'll see. Now let's go up to the green where NASA has a putt for an eagle. This is to get to 16 under par, and suddenly she'll be right up there.
Well, and I think if you're NASA and you're standing on this tee shot, you've got to be thinking that eagle's the way to go, because you know that you're trying to chase, you're trying to make up ground, and with this hole playing so short today, you know everybody's going to have a great look at birdie. So in order to kind of claw one back, get ahead of everybody else, you've got to think about eagle. And this is an interesting putt, I think. You know, when you're past the hole like this, even though there's going to be a little bit of movement to the right, you're playing back into the wind, and it's quite strong even down here by the green. And you're going to have to hit it a little bit up the hill into that slope. It's going to take it back round to the right to start with. And I think you've got to be fairly aggressive with this. This is not one that you can be tentative with if you want to get it there.
NASA started the day three shots back. She dropped a shot on her second hole of the day. Whereas Mel Reid had made a birdie early, so she was five behind and now has this to tie the lead. So that'll be a tap-in birdie. Three-time winner on the tour. Eighth-ranked player in the world.
Just a really talented... we've seen her play some great golf, good driver of the golf ball, but I spoke with her caddy, Greg Johnston, and asked, you know, what's her strength? And he, of course, said ball striking, but then he said her mental game. And at 21 years old, he doesn't feel like she acts that way on the golf course, makes smart decisions, very focused player both on and off the golf course.
This is how it looks right now. We have a tie at the top, Reid and Song. Coming out to the ninth hole here, and Jennifer Song with her second. Do you think she can get this there?
If she digs it out of there with any kind of solid contact, easily, just 195 front, downwind, and that has plenty on it. A little right.
Easy
to get lucky at this point.
Yeah, it's going to run into that rough.
Yeah, but it's going to stay short of the bad stuff on the hill.
Might be a tricky shot, though, to get the ball to stop.
I think that's actually part of the... Not that she couldn't have easily gotten there with a good shot. Part of the reason on this hole location, you don't want to be laying up. This is when you want to get it down there as far as possible, because that hole is just protected by a little bit of elevation as you go into it, and it slopes away past the hole. It's going to make it difficult with any sort of wedge in hand.
That's exactly what it's gone.
Straight down the breeze.
Do you agree? Yeah, six for sure. We only need it to help 5 yards. We need to help you out, right? You might have a touch of running across the flood once you're down. I'll just, like, finish it next time.
plays uphill.
Pardon me? 100%.
Uphill 2 yards, but downwind at least 10. 182 hole, 175 front. This is 6 iron, great angle. Starts a little right. Looks like plenty of club center of the green.
Took a really soft second bounce. She might have been a bit unlucky there. He's going to try and edge down the hill, but I don't think he's going to have enough pace to go very far. I think if that had just kicked on a couple of bounces, it would have been fine. But as you mentioned, Paige, that little rise up into the green, and I think that second bounce just kicked right into it and took all the momentum out of it. Now, Kupcho.
Just a 7 iron for Jennifer. That little natural draw can get close here.
It's going to depend on the bounce.
Very nice line, just right of the hole.
And that just died as well.
Saw it bounce.
Just playing so differently than a lot of the other years that we've been here. That would have been on the back edge some of those years.
All right, Karen, here is the proven winner among the contenders, Nasa Hataoka.
I know, and she's just sneaking up on everybody right now. This one back into wind off the right slightly, and this one drifting a bit to the right.
So going into the wind at 8 and now 10, she's lost it right. Mel Reid, the 33-year-old from England. Jennifer Song, the 30-year-old from the U.S., a dual citizen, Korea and America, tied for the lead.
Back on the green at the 9th. Jennifer Kupcho, all downhill from here, isn't it, Jerry?
Yeah, it is, and you mentioned it with Jennifer Song's pitch shot. She already played it and tried hitting one that would spin, and it just jumped out of there. Just went screaming across the other side of the green, and I think she is actually going to play. They just pointed at each other. She's going to play her fourth shot first.
So that's the ball in the rough. Just see it poking its head out.
Much easier this one to get close than the previous one, but still not a bargain. Has to loft it a little bit, land it on the green.
Trouble is you got to get a little bit of speed to get through this rough, but you don't want it to go very far, so it's a little delicate. Make sure there's open face.
Stubbed it a bit.
Yep. Almost a little decel on that downswing as well.
It's hard to trust it, to trust that your club's going to slide through the rough. You saw how much she gripped down on it to try to take some of the force away from swinging at it. But just a challenge now on this par 5 to try to save par.
Yeah, easiest hole on the golf course. And the last thing you want to be doing is scrambling for a 5. It's been a tie for the lead.
Well, she parred number 3, which is the other reachable par 5 on this front 9.
Now Kupcho.
Very slippery, as you know, turning left early. This will erase the memories from a hole ago. Quickly, hopefully, if she makes it.
Yeah, double bogey at the 8th.
Just really want to get the speed right here.
Didn't need much more, did it? Let's go up to the 11th. Brooke Henderson has this for birdie, flag today towards the back of this green. So good tee shot from Brooke, middle of the putting surface. Just trying to ease it down there, but a little too tentative. Can't afford to be tentative at this point in the tournament. She needs to go get it if she's going to win. Remains at 11 under par, 5 behind. And we go back over to the 9th and Mel Reid for an eagle.
Nearly identical putt to Kupcho's.
See if she learned anything about the speed. Looks like it's, I don't know, no, not quite. Still, can't get too carried away. It is a birdie for Mel, and she goes out in two under par. Although she made those back-to-back bogeys, that's a good front nine.
Yeah, and able to, more importantly, put those two bogeys behind her right immediately with those two birdies. And there's something about the turn that helps you kind of flip the page anyway.
Back up the hill at the 11th. Great look here for Altamare. Yeah, good two there. Three in a row for Brittany. Had to cancel her wedding. She was going to get married in Tuscany. And because of the COVID issues, she's going to delay it a year. And Jennifer Song working hard for a par at this very easy ninth hole.
Yeah, and all because of the third shot. When you get in a position like that where she was, you see all that green with which to work, you just can't resign yourself to trying to make par from there. And that's likely what she should have been trying to do, play something along the ground, maybe 15 feet, and take your chances. But tried hitting the hero shot, and there was just such a low probability on it. Oh, but it doesn't matter now.
Well, it's a good scramble in the end. It's hard work, but that is a very important par for Jennifer Song. And she also goes out in two under. Great chance to break through and win for the first time on the LPGA Tour. Nine to go. Kupcho now. This one needs a little bit of thought.
Not a whole lot. Match play, I'm not sure you'd be putting this.
You might see me putting it, Jerry, but well, not these top players.
That's a huge difference.
Yep. Good birdie in the end. Bounces back after that double, but she'll be disappointed in going out and level par. Finds herself three behind, so work to do for Kupcho. Let's go to the 10th.
And Hataoka with the mask on.
Yeah, she had to take a little bit of time before she played this shot, and this one's going to come up short, but the reason for the mask, I believe, is that she was tilting her head back, holding tissues, and I'm speculating that it was a nosebleed. Mm.
That's going to leave a very difficult little chip shot as well.
Let's go to the 15th hole. Flag today in the middle of the green, a fairly flat part of this putting surface. Lexi Thompson is one under for the day, and she will remain one under for the day. Seven under overall, tied for 19th. She'll be excited to cruise up to Philadelphia, potentially in a very nice vehicle, if you have seen her social media posts. And head to the KPMG Women's PGA.
Right at the 10th, making the turn with the same one-shot lead she had when she teed off at 1 today. Mel Reid.
I feel like a lot has happened in that amount of time, though.
Yeah.
It
was a circuitous route to get there. Now let's see how Kupcho bounces back.
Peculiar play here. It was a hole where you didn't see hardly any drivers the first 3 days, but pretty much majority of the field hitting driver today because it is straight into the breeze. It's going to be in the fairway, left center.
Much different strike than the one she had at 8. Much longer shot than Reid. Jennifer Song is a player who tends to play her best when conditions aren't their best. She has great records in major championships, including that playoff runner-up at the ANA Inspiration and ShopRite LPGA Classics year in, year out, Jerry, tend to be birdie fests.
Mm-hmm. Starts off a little right. It's going to be just fine and a pretty good angle from there as well.
Should say that 17 under par is the tournament record. That's for a three-day event. And Mel Reid leads it at the moment at that 17 under number. Third shot at that 10th for Hataoka.
And it is a difficult one, as Paige was saying. Very delicate from the rough, not a lot of green to use.
landed nice and soft for her. It was some good touch.
That'll be a bending par putt for Nasa Hataoka. Mel Reid trying to follow up Georgia Hall, her countrywoman, who won 2 weeks ago. Par putt for Nasa Hataoka just a moment ago at 10.
Well, and this putt is difficult, but there is a large sense of urgency about this group. Now, they've lost a bit of ground.
And now live to drop one. So three shots behind Mel Reid, the leader, who's in the group right behind her. Kupcho hit three wood. She'll go first here at 10. You see she is tied for third with Hataoka.
I think you just need to...
Even giving up 20 plus yards to her fellow competitors, still only 127 the hole. Not the most difficult shot of the day, but it is straight into the breeze, and you really have to control that spin. 9-iron. Even with a 9-iron, which has taken one more club than she would normally hit from this distance, it can still easily climb.
Yeah, especially into the wind.
Stay there. Go over.
That looks good.
How about the spin?
Really nice.
Oh, beautifully done.
Really nice.
I'll be curious to hear from her after this run. This is the first time she's really had a chance to win late. She's tied for second at Evian, but she made a late run. She never really was in contention, but... comparing that to the pressure of the Augusta National Women's Amateur around that golf course. All right, Mel Reid trying to back up the victory from Georgia Hall 2 weeks ago, the last time English players won back-to-back LPGA Tour events. 1996.
Touch off the shoulder very safely. If you go at the pin, the back is 118, playing 25. So I like a touch off the shoulder. I think that's perfect. Finishing maybe a yard or two left.
You heard it, Trish Johnson, Caroline Pierce. You saw that statistic, trying to follow up her friend Georgia.
Like the signal was a little wedge. Des telling her there's a little bit of hurt from the right as well. A lot of hurt, but a little from the right.
Okay. It's going to be pretty straightforward. Maybe a little right to left on this putt upcoming.
No fans to tell her how good it was. She can't see it quite yet. That's what the players are seeing. Jennifer Song has put the half windbreaker on here.
Knocking it by Mel Reid as well. That was a little unexpected. This is right.
It sounded a little tinny. Saw... both of the other players a little more crisp, a little more down at it, just a little tinny on that.
Well, Mel Reid's career began to move in an upward direction when she made the sacrifice to come to the U.S. And take a look at English players who've won on tour. Laura Davies, 20 of them, the first of which was a U.S. Open here in the state of New Jersey. And there are Trish Johnson and Caroline Pierce, who went back to back. Moving to the U.S., according to Mel Reid, has been a huge part of her upward trend.
The opportunity out here in America is just, you know, it's night and day to England. Like, you can practice every single day. You know what the weather's going to do. It's made a huge impact on me, to be honest with you. It's allowed me to actually plan downtime and plan preps for the season. And it's just a lot easier. Obviously, it's hard leaving home. You know, my heart is in England, obviously, but left all my friends and families over there. But you know, it's a sacrifice you have to do if you want to be one of the world's best. And, you know, it's something that took me a while to do, but I'm very grateful that I did it. And, yeah, I mean, it's obviously turned out really good for me.
a big sacrifice. It also gives her a chance to play with some major champions on the men's side down in Florida.
Yeah, she was not shy about the fact that she'd gotten in Brooks Koepka's pocket a time or two when they played some money games down in South Florida. And there is some truth to that. Surrounding yourself by players that are also high quality, they do it for a living, you can learn a lot from each other and their processes.
All right, Brittany Altomare with three straight birdies trying to keep the momentum up. Par putt.
12 is a tricky hole. We're going to see that from the leaders coming through in a little bit. Short par 4, a lot of drop off on both sides of the green. And if you're not able to hit the green, then oftentimes we see players walking away with a 5.
So back to 10 under into a tie for 7th. Here's Jennifer Song. Have a read here, Jerry.
Yeah, not a good shot, but still a reasonable chance here from 20 plus feet. Downhill pretty darn quick, turning just a hair right early and then probably falling a little left at the end, but not a ton for my read. Putting stroke is as smooth as a golf swing.
Die hard there, yeah. Brooke Henderson had the same putt from earlier. At 12th, Brooke Henderson playing with Brittany Altomare. She also has this for par. Fairway bunker off the tee, missed the green. This is it's a tough green to hit even if you're coming from the fairway. Stays at 11 under. You'd say too far back probably for most people, but we've seen Brooke Henderson do some amazing things in her young LPGA career. Now an opportunity for Mel Reid here at 10.
Great opportunity here. And just like Paige said, turning just a little bit left. Putting stats for the season, the worst stats on the books for Mel, but of late, the last few weeks, she seems to have figured something out. There's nothing technically wrong with her putting stroke, that's for sure. That turned a lot more than I saw. Oh, my goodness.
You just dove. And sometimes you just got to walk away saying, I hit the putt how I wanted to, and let's, you know, try to get the next opportunity. You can't control once the ball leaves the club face.
Long birdie putt at the 11th for Hataoka.
Does sort of a soft, gentle slope down and to the left.
It's just on a lot of these greens, Karen, it's really difficult to get a sense of the pace, and I think that was a prime example there.
And now Jennifer Kupcho with a chance to erase the double bogey at 8. She birdied 9 and has this for birdie at 10.
You know, Grant, back at 6, just before we came on there, she hit a mediocre iron shot that missed the green short and kind of slammed the club against her foot with enough force to where I would have been a little concerned if I were a family member. But I think that showed a lot of the fire, not just the frustration, but the fire inside, how much fight she has. And she's showing it now. What a great approach shot, straight up the hill.
Yes. Answers the double with back-to-back birdies, and she's back in the mix within 2 of Mel Reid as they make their way to the par 3 11th. Golf Channel and the LPGA Tour welcome you back to the Jersey Shore. It's the ShopRite LPGA Classic presented by Acer. Grant Boone, Paige McKenzie, Tom Abbott, Jerry Foltz and Karen Stupples, and our entire crew. Mel Reid for birdie at the 8th.
Yeah, after back-to-back bogeys on 6 and 7, it was a great bounce back to kind of get her momentum back moving in the right direction.
Yeah, that would be followed up by a birdie at the 9th. And so it's Reid by 1 of her song and back-to-back birdies for Jennifer Kupcho, the 23-year-old American who's also looking for her first LPGA Tour title.
Now, so Hataoka made her par putt here to remain at 14 under. So now back slightly up the hill to the tee, and Kupcho.
Wind from the left, and obviously some help in it. Jennifer going with 7-iron here. That seems on the edge between 7 and 6 for Jennifer. But the green does slope away a little bit, although this week they haven't been releasing much. Today, quite a bit firmer than they have been the first few days. Sticking with the 7.
Yeah, to touch on what you said, Jerry, about, you know, her toughness, that Augusta National Women's Am, she, you know, won with a migraine. And then even talking to her mom and former college coach, Diane Daly, she has a little bit of chip on her shoulder just from not being a highly recruited amateur. It's kind of motivated her to her success. Coming out of Colorado, you know they make them a little tougher in the cold weather, too.
This is left of the hole if it gets back there.
It's going to leave her a tough one. You might say the same about turning pro. All the attention was on Farsi. You know, she was getting big endorsement deals and was getting a lot of publicity. Kupcho just kind of quietly going about her business, and a lot of attention still centered on Farsi, but yet Kupcho has finished as a runner-up in a major. It was at Evian, as we mentioned. Now Mel Reid.
A lot of attention on Mel Reid as a young professional as well, and is, I mean, destined for superstardom, and her career just ascended steadily and meteorically for those first 3 or 4 years, and then, of course, beset by the family tragedy. And now she seems to be on a very similar type of rise. That is 6-iron, just right of the hole.
Good job, bud.
That's a much better effort. Really, that's really good.
That's excellent. And Jerry, when you've played this golf course so many times year in and year out, and you know that if you just land it on the front edge, it typically skips all the way to the back, on years like this where it's playing so soft, sometimes it's just hard to pull enough club on a green that doesn't give you much from as far as slope from back to front.
It is, and it's just as hard around the greens when you're used to those things just running out, your little chip and runs, pitching pitch shots and what have you, and now you find yourself having to fly them halfway there. So we had 7 for Kupcho, 6 for Mel. This is a 5-iron for Jennifer Song. Starts a little right, staying there. That's the wide part of the green.
He's not in any trouble.
Well, it's time now for hashtag Aced It, presented by Acer, and a look at a memorable hole-in-one from just a few weeks ago at the ANA Inspiration. Linnaeus Strum, hole number 8, 8-iron, 161 yards, perfection. Each time a hole-in-one is made on the LPGA Tour this season, follow Acer America on Twitter and Facebook for your chance to enter to win an Acer laptop. Brittany Altomare made an ace at the 17th hole Thursday. And players who make an ace this year on the OPG Tour get a laptop from Acer. How's 13.
It? Yeah, 13th hole. Brooke Henderson second. Today cut over on the left, and it's a narrow tier, but with this green being soft all week, it makes it a bit easier. You can see Brooke was able to throw it in and actually get the ball to spin back. Recent champions here at the ShopRite LPGA Classic, only one of these players making the ShopRite their first victory. That's Annie Park in 2018. And if you look at this list, it's very impressive. Major champions abound. Only two of these players have not won majors, Annie Park and Aimee Azarte. So quality seems to rise to the top here on this golf course, maybe because it's an old Donald Ross and you've got to think your way around.
To 12, and the second shot for Nasa Hataoka.
She's got 123, and the grass is growing into her. The tendency is to want to keep this low, but when the grass is that fluffy around it, it's so difficult, and that just came out tough.
It's probably the easiest pitch shot around the green if you were to miss the green, if we want to try to find a silver lining.
11 again.
Is Jay Monahan out watching her again today, Jay?
Yeah, I've enjoyed my chats with Jay Monahan the last couple of days, Tom.
It's hard to believe that Jay's out there.
Jay Monahan, of course. We know it. The viewer doesn't yet, but that's Jennifer Kupcho's boyfriend. Works at a superstition.
Not the Jay Monahan.
He is the Jay Monahan, if you ask his parents. But he's not the PGA Tour commissioner, no. No. Met out in Phoenix, or actually East Mesa, Superstition Mountain. And quite a good player himself. Played college golf in Iowa. I forget the name of the school.
Gotcha.
But I hadn't heard of Mercer before I met you either, Tom.
Well, now you have. You know, yes. It's a seat of learning. But he must have no issue with getting free golf for Jay Monahan, or getting entertained very well wherever he goes. All he has to do is call and say, hey, it's Jay Monahan. Yeah.
Could you imagine dinner reservations the week of the players?
Yeah, let's see what Kupcho can do.
Really tough to get the speed right here. Green slopes away from you the entire way. It's just so much faster than you see when you walk up to the green, and you had to hit it uphill the first few feet. That's going to get there.
That one left par, bit of work to do for Kupcho, but it was always going to be tricky leaving it short. Players are allowed two guests to accompany them, hence the reason that Jay Monahan is here. Other than that, there are nobody outside of the ropes watching, unless they are official guests. Now at the 13th, Brittany Altomare from that lower level. You can see the ridge runs from front to back. The upper side of the green's narrower. This is a tricky putt, Paige.
It's going to be moving from her left to right and just slow up that hill. A lot of times I would walk up halfway and just picture it as two putts to try to get a feel for it. That got a little bit of work left to do.
See the Seaview Resort in the background. Grand old hotel, a huge hotel. It's been renovated in the last couple of years now. Jennifer Song.
Consistently downhill to the hole, not quite as fast as the one Kupcho just had. Little change in the subtle brakes here, going a little left early, and then should just fall right at the end. Line was good.
Third shot for Hataoka at 12.
And this feels like the shot she should be playing, a sort of a low running shot. But if she wanted to, she could have flown that quite close to the hole and it would have stopped. Plenty of options with these softer conditions.
Yeah, it's just about picking.
This is a moment ago, Jennifer Kupcho for par at the 11th. And a good save. I believe some of you may not have seen that the first time around. May have had a few technical issues, but hopefully those have been ironed out. Mel Reid for birdie.
Pretty straight-looking putt here. Maybe just turning a little right.
Right in the heart.
Rare birdie here.
Yeah, good birdie for Mel Reid. So she stretches ahead by two at the top of the leaderboard, and Maya, she bounced back after those back-to-back bogeys. She had three birdies in four holes. Let's go to the 13th, and Brooke Henderson for birdie. She knew she'd hit it just a bit too hard right away. Get back to 11, and Jennifer Song for par. No, subtle movement in some of these greens fooled her.
Yeah, it's one of the greens out here that does slope from the front to the back. Oftentimes when you're pin high, you anticipate that it will always be breaking towards the front of the green. In this case, breaking towards the water, towards the ocean, Reed's Bay.
Boy, this is a dramatic change. It was a bunched up leaderboard, now Reed by three at 12.
All the fairways are important. This one probably the most. She's watching that closely up the left.
Uh-oh.
That's not good.
No, just a small, small landing area on the green. This is one of those holes that you desperately want to be in the fairway. Even though it's a short iron in hand, it's usually just a wedge. Very important to hit the fairway on this hole. That's going to leave a really difficult approach.
It's been a day for enduring adversity. Kupcho bounced back from a double to make back-to-back birdies. Here she is at 12.
And much like the eighth hole, this is a hole where I'd like to see players hit a little more club off the tee, because even though it is just a short wedge in, it's the most treacherous one of the year. And even if you're in the rough, getting it somewhere around the edge of the green where it's an easy up and down is a lot easier if you can control it. That's going to leave a lengthy shot in and a bad angle from there.
And so Jennifer Song had the lead outright after seven holes. Now she trails by three. Said she prefers to be the chaser, not the one being chased. And she's going to have to now in the last seven holes.
There aren't a lot of holes of those last seven that you really feel are, you know, you step up to the tee and you think you'll be disappointed if you don't make birdie, except for the 18th. That's very low. Staying right side.
Maybe not the strike she was hoping for.
Definitely not.
Up ahead at the 12th for par, Nasa. See if she can save it.
It's not an easy putt.
Oh. So she'll drop a shot.
Just not an easy hole.
Yeah. Especially when you miss the fairway as Nasa did. She'll hustle to the 13th. But Nasa's chances are fading. Coming up, craps here in the last couple of holes. Reid, meanwhile, on a hot streak, leads it by three. All right, with Mel Reid in a fairway bunker, let's see what Kupcho can do from the fairway at 12.
Yeah, 119, and just you're hitting across this dome back green at an angle. You have to be so precise. If you're precise, you should make it look routine, but anything offline or miss hit, you pay a huge price on this hole. This has potential.
Okay.
It's just fine.
It is. Well, it's hard to be too aggressive to that back hole location. And she creates quite a bit of spin on it.
Okay, Jerry, have you had a look at Mel's situation here?
Yeah, just in a small little groove mark from a rake with a pitching wedge, same yardage, 119, straight up the angle of the green makes the shot a little more doable. Clean contact's not a given, but that was pretty impressive.
Great shot.
Oh, fantastic. How about it?
Really good, Mel.
Dez liked it, or caddy? Ryan DeVoe, yes.
That is the one great thing of having that angle, is you don't have to worry about distance control nearly as much as just making sure it's on the right line.
That was an aggressive fist bump. She was really fired up about that one. Song needs a good one here.
Yeah, just 102. Went with the full gap wedge. Little right of the hole, ballooned in the wind some. That's good.
Oh, she'll get a read as well. From Reid. Well, this went viral the other day, so we got to show it to you again. We put Mel Reid and her caddy, Dez, to the test in this week's edition of Caddy Knows Best.
Mel Reid, Ryan DeVoe, otherwise known as Dez. 10 questions specifically for you. Very tough questions. Are you guys nervous?
No.
You don't look
I'm a bit nervous by his answers, but
I would be as well.
Okay, cool.
Because I know them already. But anyway, roughly a minute from when I get done asking the first question. Your favorite snowboarding location?
Austria.
Austria. He said Whistler.
I've never been to Whistler.
He didn't know you could
go. Oh, okay. We'll go. Yeah. Okay, we'll go. Sorry.
All right. You gotta go. Last tattoo you got.
Pardon?
Last tattoo you got.
Oh, even
like, where was it?
Where was it?
Sure. Or what was it?
On my neck.
He said wrist. Favorite moment on the golf course?
With Dez. Or in general.
No,
it's gotta be Solheim.
Yes. Got it right, yeah.
Good boy.
Funniest person with whom to play golf? Come on, Des.
I mean, one of my favorite players to play with is Colotta. Did he say, who did he say, funniest?
Funniest.
Have we played with him recently?
No, this isn't, there's no hint.
Laura?
You said Laura or Conkaline?
Yeah, okay. Oh, Conk is pretty funny, yeah.
Least favorite thing to practice?
All of it.
Practice rounds?
Oh, I hate practice rounds, that's good. I do hate practice rounds.
If you weren't an athlete, what would you do?
Okay, either some sort of athlete or...
If you weren't an athlete?
Something to do with a pub, East Putt, something like that, isn't it?
Yeah, open a pub.
Open a pub,
yeah. You got it, we're giving that. If he weren't a caddy, what would he be?
Virgin.
I don't know, you guys got that right. But you did. Your favorite late night snack purchase from a grocery store?
I knew she was going to say it.
Late night snack, it's got to be chocolate.
Any superstitions on the golf course?
I use the same marker, 1950s marker.
Oh, high number golf balls.
Oh, I should have said that one. Dude.
I should have got that one.
And your celebratory beverage of choice?
Anything wet and alcoholic.
I guess high noon count.
Yeah, exactly.
Good job.
That was pretty good.
I know you did.
You never forget the first time you saw that edition of Caddy Knows Best. Mel Reid looking for her first career victory and has extricated herself from a fairway bunker to get to that point. Just a moment ago, Kupcho for birdie.
Up a slight little tear in the green. Oh, I hit a lot of hole.
She lipped out her bogey putt at 8. That one takes a right turn. And now Reid. Jerry, she's played really, really well today. She was hoping for a ruling and a drop at 6. Didn't get it from a spot that was just off the fairway. They are playing preferred lies. And then 7, she had a lip out for par. So other than that, she's been solid, hasn't she?
Yeah, she's playing like she expects this out of herself.
Mm.
And I think that's the result of all the work she's done with her team.
For a 4-shot lead. Yes! Well, she didn't shy away. Did she? When she was talking about what today would mean, she said it would be life-changing to be an established winner on the LPGA Tour against the best in the world. It changes your career and your life, she said. She moves a step closer. Now to 19 under par. Brooke Henderson at 14. How do you fancy her chances next week at Aronimink?
I expect that she will show up well. She does tend to play great in majors as well as more traditional golf courses. That is what I expect from next week.
Jennifer Song for birdie.
Almost identical line. Got the perfect read from Mel.
Not going to get very many great opportunities like that. We're starting to run out of holes.
So in the last 5 holes, she's gone from 1 ahead to 4 behind. A lot of that has been because of Mel Reid, but she did bogey for the first time since the second round on Friday. And now Kupcho for her par. I mean, we've said it, a 4-shot lead, you know, you'd think Mel's in control, but there are some places where you can lose a golf ball around here.
Yeah, I mean, there's volatility in these last finishing holes.
Yeah.
There's no doubt about it. Nothing is for sure. This, you know, she needs to get down right now, but also remember the win at Augusta National Women's Amateur, she was 5 under on her last 6 holes.
Yeah.
So she's got the firepower to make something happen, potentially in these last finishing holes, which she's going to have to do. Unless Mel Reid starts to give something back.
She does have a flair for the dramatic, doesn't she? There are players who seem to have that little something. Just her second year. 13.
Wow, this is not the place to miss it from Hadaoka.
No, but there's a nice little flat spot that she can land it on.
Wow.
What a shot that was.
Great shot. That was awesome. Just the guts to be able to take that shot on.
All right, we've got final round coverage of the PGA Tour Sanderson Farms Championship coming your way next. Sergio Garcia playing in the final grouping, looking for his first victory since the Masters 3 years ago. Coming your way when we are done here at Seaview, which has been, as always, a most hospitable host. The 32nd playing of the ShopRite LPGA Classic presented by Acer.
Beautiful look back down the 13th.
The most comfortable wind for a right-handed golfer, Tom. Downwind with a little bit off the right. You get this wind on the driving range, you hit a bucket of balls, you feel like Tiger Woods.
Yeah, good.
It just, yeah, there's so much more confidence when you got this wind. You step up and hit driver fearlessly. And that's not short.
No, anything downwind, anything with a little bit of help, helps kind of minimize any waywardness.
And of course, you always look to the other end of the range and saw the good players who were practicing into the wind.
Also true.
Jennifer Song.
Left.
And into what looks to be not a great spot over there because it wasn't bouncing much, was it? So it could be some issues for Jennifer Song. There are a couple of bunkers down that left side, and we'll just have to see how it's lying, assuming it's in the bunker. Now, Kupcho.
Last time Mel hit a good one downwind, Kupcho's went trundling by easily. See if she does it again here. If so, it's just some sort of wedge in. Yeah, good one.
Take that one every day. Kupcho really impressive with the way she's driving the golf ball.
Yeah, she gets quite a bit of power, and she has this very predictable right-to-left shot, which, once she hits the fairways, she'll get a little bit more rollout.
How about the follow-up to the playoff disappointment, losing to Georgia Hall in Portland? This week for Ashley Buhai, this is her third shot at 18. The par 5, she would tap that in. And she's tied for 5th. 2 weeks ago, though she lost in the playoff, she punched a ticket to the U.S. Women's Open. And this week, players have a chance who aren't already qualified to get into the U.S. Women's Open in December if they're the top two players within the top 10 on the leaderboard. This is Mina Haraguy for a closing birdie. Is it enough? Oh, ooh, just enough. Like Jennifer Song, a USGA champion, 2007 U.S. Public Links champ. 4 rounds under par and a tie for 5th. She had a really busy time during the shutdown.
Yeah, she played quite a few mini tour events and won a few, so she's been playing some great golf since the COVID break.
Mel Reid is playing great golf and doing it again today. She leads by 4.
Well, between the bunkers for Jennifer Song at the 13th.
They rolled all the way through that first bunker, and this is a really nice lie from 142. Might need to sit just a bit.
Yeah. Well, if it just comes back. There, it's better than being in the rough. Maybe even better than being on that lower tier. So Altamari with a tough putt. Now Mel Reid.
Looks like gap wedge from 107. Got a little help. If you hit it hole high and left of the hole, it'll come down off the hill, which is left of the green.
No problem there at all.
If you could just bottle out that wedge shot, those wedge shots that she's hit over the course of this week have been just beautiful, patient, nice transition at the top. When you have, you know, those three-quarter, you're manufacturing a shot so often, it's easy to rush it. And she's just shown a lot of patience in her golf swing today.
Yeah, 3 good ones in a row at 10, 12, and 13 mm-hmm. as well.
She talked about that yesterday, didn't she? Learning from getting too quick in Portland and slowing things down, taking her time today. Kupcho.
Sand wedge, 93 yards.
That might get a little hot back towards the green.
It was left enough to get a little help.
So good look at birdie there for Kupcho. He's still battling away. Four behind, but certainly not out of it. Let's go to 18.
Yeah, a very different feel for Lexi Thompson at the closing hole. First of all, it's a 72-hole event, not 54 like it normally is, and when she won it last year, but she made eagle to come from behind to beat Jong-un Lee 6. And she'll have that for eagle to finish up her defense this year. 15.
And Brooke Henderson on the tee.
And you know it's a long hole when she's got a metal wood out.
Yeah, it just plays a little bit uphill, doesn't it, Paige? And then the breeze today out of the east, so crosswind here. Blowing right to left.
Yeah, and when she's got that normal draw shot, the wind tends to amplify it, especially in that direction, but able to hang on to the putting surface.
It's been a busy day for the Korda siblings. Sebastian Korda lost to his idol Rafa Nadal in the fourth round of the French Open this morning. And, Jessica and Nelly are finishing up now.
Did you get up this morning?
I did. Yeah, and it was really cool. Really fun to watch Seb, as they call him.
He did come into the booth this morning before our broadcast and blamed me for telling him the wrong time.
Right, because you said it was 4 a.m.
It wasn't me. I just want to make that clear. But yeah, you were up and ready to watch a three-hour pregame.
Sure. I was well ready.
Jennifer Song now. I thought it was interesting that the Korda sisters named their cat after Rafa Nadal. I'm not sure that's ever been... never happened before in a Grand Slam that a player on court has a cat named after his opponent. Now, Jennifer Song.
I got nothing. Downhill lie. And clip that. Maybe clipped it a little too
nicely. Yeah, I didn't expect that kind of spin.
No.
Can't afford to make any mistakes that far back. Let's go to 18 again.
How about another eagle on Sunday for Lexi Thompson? It won't be to win.
It's a good look at what that putt's going to do. I anticipate most of these players coming in will be able to go for this green in two, and there's a little bit of an upslope at the very front of the green. It'd actually be difficult to keep the ball short of that.
That tap in will take, that'll take her to 9-under at the moment, tied for 10th.
The way Mel Reid is playing right now, Jerry, you feel like she's going to hole everything.
You do, yeah. Even the putt she missed at 10, she hit where she wanted to. Took her club length left to take a little of a break out of this.
Wow, that moved a lot.
Yeah, early.
It looked like it almost tried to come back a little bit at the end. It might have just bobbled.
I think 19-under is probably going to be good enough, although Kupcho will have other ideas. And has a good look at birdie here to close the gap to 3. Mel very much in the zone from the way she's played over the last 6 holes. Before Kupcho putts, I think it's going to be Jennifer Song.
This group playing a little more quickly now because the group in front with NASA has been placed on the clock, so they've kind of put the pedal down a little bit and creating a little distance. When they do time the group in front, the rules officials let you know so that you can try and keep pace and ultimately don't end up on the clock. And with Mel Reid committed to slowing things down a little bit internally, not physically so much, it's maybe just a little point of curiosity at this point.
Yeah, good four. Good four for Jennifer. 220th start on the LPGA Tour, and you've got to get to a point where you wonder if it's going to happen. You only have so many chances, and today was a great chance for Jennifer. Not necessarily out of it, but four behind at the moment, playing against Mel Reid, who seems incredibly comfortable. Kupcho going through the motions of trying to get a feel for.
I love that technique.
That pop, yeah.
I just, well, I'm a big fan of being able to read the greens with your feet. That's why I like that narrow-soled shoe and having that, be able to feel the contour a little bit better.
And you can practice in the dark.
Also true.
Mm. Night putting.
Well, if the were to get dark, or if you know, there's, you're in the shadows, you can trust your feet.
Yeah, nice. She's closed the gap by one. So Kupcho to 16 under par, three behind, with five holes to play. I think that a Reid versus Kupcho match will come up in the Solheim Cup at some stage in the next several playings. Maybe not in the singles, but in the pairs competition.
You played against Mel Reid in a Curtis Cup singles,
in
didn't
Curtis
you?
In Curtis Cup, yeah.
It says here, McKenzie D. Reid.
You know what? It doesn't... I played well that week. I played well that week, but... I've known that Mel Reid was a great player for a very long time, and I think that's one of the things that I did learn. There was a couple players on that GB&I team that I knew would have standout careers, and Mel was one of them.
All right, here is Kupcho off the birdie, three back.
Into the wind from the left, not ideal. Gentle little dogleg to the right. Not a hole you get up to the tee and consider a birdie hole, but right now that's pretty much all she is thinking. So that was hit nicely. Really nicely. Low, penetrating ball flight.
Big hop.
And just one more point on Mel. I mentioned earlier that she had gone head-to-head against Japan when she was a single playing a best ball at the International Crown in 16, and this is what she said. She said, I would say that I play my best when I'm under severe pressure, not just in golf, but in life. I've been under quite a bit of pressure in many situations, but there's something that switches inside of me where when I'm under severe pressure, I just turn it on. And I know she's going to be feeling the pressure coming down the stretch, especially with Kupcho just making that birdie on 13.
And you can't teach it, can you? That is awesome. It's a mark of a champion.
Will she be a champion on the LPGA Tour for the first time? She's got a three-shot lead with five to play. She and Kupcho in the fairway at the par 4, 14th. The 33-year-old from England, Solheim Cup stalwart, six times a winner in Europe, maybe for the first time here. NASA's chances are fading here at Seaview for par.
They are. She spent the whole time down the right side of this hole. And really, she just hasn't been able to get everything going since she had issues down the 10 with her nose.
Henderson now for birdie. Too much. Brooke in some good form, though. I think she will be confident heading to Aronimink for the KPMG Women's PGA.
Back at the 14th, 30-year-old American born in Ann Arbor, Michigan. Parents were in school at University of Michigan. Dad an engineer, mom a concert pianist. Song second at 14.
Down the hill, into the wind, quartering in from the left, 160 to the hole. I think it's 5-iron. That's flying like a 6. It's a good shot if it gets back there. And I was always going to struggle, but not horrible.
Thank you, I will.
Just not a lot of options left, or a lot of opportunities left, excuse me. It's disappointing when you hit a good shot, it's just not quite the right club.
Said she wanted to be aggressive going into this final round today. Comes up short there.
29 cover. I think we're playing this right now more at 10:30.
Right now it's perfect. You can certainly trap this. Let's finish at 5 left.
just on the hole there.
Yeah, that's perfect. Only 29 to get up top. This is good.
Chuck it, yeah?
100%.
9 iron, 137 total yards is the hole. Just the shot they were looking for. If it's the club.
Great shot, bud.
Yeah. It's not the release that you would expect. This typically one of the firmest greens. That was a safe play.
She's hitting fairways and greens, making Kupcho come and get her. Kupcho birdied 13. How will she play this 14th?
And typically one of the tougher holes on the back, but with a tee shot like this into the wind, it becomes a birdie hole. 121 and a pitching wedge.
Yeah, wait for the stuff.
Just three steps off the right-hand side, so not a lot of room over there. Target will probably just be on the left side of that flag, maybe between Mel's ball and the flag.
Started left of that, coming back a bit.
Maybe equidistant, not sure who will go first there. Mel Reid leads by three, birdie putts for the top two when we come back. Birdie putt for Jennifer Song at 14.
Up the hill initially, turning right the whole way.
Our chances continue to slip away. She'll have four holes left. Nelly Korda. Just saw Jessica a moment ago. This is her second at the par 5 18th.
That is so good.
Say.
There's not a lot of players that can launch it that high and land it.
12 feet.
Birdied 17, so that's a putt to get to fourth place alone in her first event since the A&A Inspiration playoff loss. Mel Reid at 14.
Learned a fair bit from Song's putt. And just maybe about 8 inches to a foot outside the left, get the speed right.
I'm both a little fooled. Sometimes even if you see your, you know, the other player in your group hit a putt, it still maybe just doesn't make sense, doesn't feel right. And both underread it.
You may not know 100% if they struck it just the way they wanted to strike the putt.
Also true. There were certain players that I knew would hit great putts, so I was willing to trust their line. And obviously you don't trust every one of them, but...
How much did Kupcho learn from those two putts? Anything?
Well, hers is quite a bit different line, but still a similar break. It, a little bit of movement to the right. Hers is a little more downhill at the end. This hole is placed just on the right side, as you play the whole right side of a little crown. Another gust of wind really picking up, which is basically blowing straight across the line from the left.
Did she?
Oof.
Wow.
That looked good for a long time.
Reed's not in yet. She's got about 3.5-4 feet. These Poana greens late in the afternoon. No gimmies. At 16, Brooke Henderson. Like Nelly Korda, first event since that playoff loss to Miriam Lee at the A&A Inspiration.
I'll have a little bit more work to do. That 16th hole is on a bit of a center tier.
Mm-hmm. Par putts for Reid, but first Song.
Important putts for both players. You just want to stay as close as you can for Jennifer Song and make sure you're not making mistakes to backpedal. And of course the same goes for Mel Reid. Don't want to open the door, especially this late in the game. She's got the number of holes are on her side at this point.
Now Reid to stay up by three. It was almost a Kevin Na move. Had it before it hit the bottom of the cup. Well, if this happens, no one will be surprised. Mel Reid is a champion in every way, trying to become an LPGA champ. Golf Channel and the LPGA welcome you back to the Jersey Shore. It's the ShopRite LPGA Classic presented by Acer, Grant Boont, and Paige McKenzie with Tom Abbott, Jerry Foltz, and Karen Stupples. Mel Reid, the leader by one coming into the day, trailed by one through seven, but has moved back in front in a big way. She leads by three. She was one shot back after back-to-back bogeys at six and seven, but she birdied eight and nine, then 11 and 12. And the 33-year-old from Derby, England, is four holes away from her first LPGA Tour title. Nelly Korda finishing up her final round for Eagle. Save that for next week at the KPMG Women's PGA.
Yeah, some days the putts drop, and some days they just burn the edge.
But, a lot of them, 66 yeah. Today. What a day for the Kordas, getting to watch their brother play in the French Open this morning against his idol Rafa. To the 15th.
Yeah, just after a little wait here for this group, Kupcho ready to play.
Feels like the wind's pretty much straight across from the right. Maybe a little hurt, and this a hybrid.
Probably the easiest hole location of the week, right in the middle of the green.
Yeah, but on one of the toughest holes.
Yeah.
That is way left. That might hit your booth. Look out, Tom.
Oh, my word, it did.
If you heard that in our mics,
we're okay.
I'm not sure if that helped her. It doesn't look like it did at all. It's gone into the really deep stuff.
Yeah, it's a challenge with a draw ball flight and a right-to-left wind. And if you pull it at all, it can get away from you long left pretty quick.
The way that ball flew, this wind might actually be helping, because that thing went a long, long ways.
Okay.
And Reid going with 5-iron, which is normally not a 197 club for her. And that's fanned out right.
Yeah.
That's safer shot, but it's not good.
And sit down. It's going to be just on the upslope there. The high camera flattens everything out, but there's quite a lot of undulation to the right. Maybe a reaction to seeing Kupcho hit it way left. Get a great view of how far left our booth is when you look at it from behind the tee.
Missed the window.
That would have been quite something if she'd hit it through the window. There you go, there's the booth over there, just above Jennifer's head, so that is...
Well, we already had one announcer get hit in the head this week with a golf ball. But that's a different story.
Different story, and I survived, we're good.
Yes.
Jennifer now.
That's up into the breeze, it's going to land softly, maybe right front, or maybe even a little deeper in the green than that.
Yeah.
Come back nice from shot. There. It should come back a little bit. Yeah,
it's got a little bit of everything on this hole.
Well, but Jennifer Song walks away with a good chance for a birdie. We haven't had too many here at 15 today, just six birdies. Playing as the sixth hardest hole on the golf course, but certainly going to be interesting to see what Mel Reid and Jennifer Kupcho can do. Let's go to 16.
And Brooke Henderson trying to get to 12 under and a tie for fourth.
You're about halfway up. It's got a tier that, yep, you can see it kind of turn left off of and slow down. It's a good lag putt. Becomes a difficult birdie from down below.
Take a look at the Rolex World Rankings. Jin Young Ko hasn't played on the LPGA Tour this season. Don't know if we'll see her. Some talk that she might come back toward the end of the year. You have the event in Tampa, the Pelican Championship, which is a new event. Then you have the U.S. Women's Open, followed by the CME Group Tour Championship. And it is worth noting that we learned this week that two sponsor exemptions are being left open at the CME Group Tour Championship, possibly for a player like Jin Young Ko, maybe for a Sofia Popoff, who won the AIG Women's Open, but didn't get that money to count on the money list because she wasn't a member when she won. So we'll see how that goes. Good days for Buhai, a second straight tournament with a great Sunday for Ashley, who lost the playoff to Georgia Hall in Portland 2 weeks ago. Mina Haragai, a great Sunday. How about Maria Fassi, who finished each nine with an eagle?
Yeah, it's an excellent day. You can see six under today. The best score, I believe, that's posted, and that included two bogeys.
Sanghyun Park is on the golf course at the moment at 6 under par, finishing up on the front nine. She's got a couple of holes to go, so maybe watch out for next week if Sanghyun Park is heading down the road, having just carded around in the mid-60s.
Yeah, Sanghyun Park is coming off a shoulder injury. She tweaked her clubs and is going to go back to her old clubs next week, her caddy. Tom Davy Jones. Yelena No got into the U.S. Women's Open by her third-place finish at the Cambia Portland Classic a couple of weeks ago. 19-year-old American phenom. Jody Ewart-Shadoff continues to make cuts and play well, looking for her first victory. And again, an opportunity for Mel Reid to back up the victory from Georgia Hall. It would be the first time in 24 years that players from England have won back-to-back tournaments on the LPGA Tour. Back to the predicament at 15.
Worst lie of the week has got to be up there, isn't it, for Kupcho in that long grass?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Well, you can see the ball clearly, but there's just, you have no idea what that grass is going to do to the club when you try and make impact. Almost always going to close it down a little bit, but you have to take a mighty swipe just to get through it. That's awesome.
Came out really well, didn't it? It was almost as though she was chipping off just the fringe grass.
That's not supposed to be that easy.
I wonder if it wasn't sitting up a little bit.
It didn't look like it to me.
Okay.
And that grass was just kind of all spider-webbed around it, but she felt comfortable she could get to the back of the ball cleanly.
It was just a wedge edge, or a machete edge on the on the wedge. That came out so nicely.
Look at this, a smooth tempo, and it just pops out.
Well, and that's big. Again, if she's trying to make up ground against Mel Reid, you didn't want to drop a shot, again, on a mistake, which putting herself in that position was a mistake, and now she's got a very, very achievable par in front of her.
How about Mel Reid over on the other side?
Yeah, just kind of trying to land it here, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, obviously giving yourself that spot right there, but knowing that a touch past is still fine, yeah? Yeah.
This lie's so bad, she called for a ruling to see if it was embedded, because it doesn't have to embed on the first, on the landing. It can embed on the bounce as well. And it wasn't granted. It is sitting way down. Chopped it out nicely. It's going to leave some work, though.
Yeah.
Back hello. Keep coming. And Mel, from that lie, it's not that bad.
Yeah. Caddy, spot on there. But Mel Reid will have that putt to remain potentially two ahead, because of course, three ahead. Kupcho has that putt to stay at 16 under on the tee at the 17th. Look what they put the flag today, right over on the right side. I went over and paced it off. It's supposed to be three paces. I think they've got short legs, whoever paced it off, because it was less than three when I walked over there earlier. Now Jennifer Song for birdie to get it to 16 under.
Make this and you never know. Potential two-shot swing with the leader.
Yeah.
And a really good shot into this green.
I mean, this is huge for Song here. I mean, if she's going to win, she's got to make a few birdies. And this is a prime opportunity. There's much in this, Jerry. It's pretty flat around the hole.
It's flat around the hole. She's standing on a bit of a side slope, so that'll make you feel like the entire putt's going to turn left, but really it's just going to do so initially.
Yeah, it looks like it's going to break more than it does.
Gave it a bit of pace as well. But you could see it almost wobble back the other direction at the end. It really just stopped moving towards the front of the green.
30 years of age, Jennifer Song. This is her 10th year on the tour.
Well, it's interesting. I was talking to her caddy, actually, you know, ahead of the round, and win, lose, or draw for Jennifer Song this week, he was just talking about how much she loves the game, which is not an abnormal statement, but maybe for somebody that's 10 years in, that's not the first thing the caddy would say in referencing, you know, how she goes about her business out here.
We talk about Mel Reid loving the pressure and being a fighter. This is the time to make a putt.
Yeah, she makes this, there'll be a little fist bump. Just going a little right early by my read.
Wow.
Huge up and down from an awful lie for Mel Reid, and she stays at 19 under par, and she's got a really good cushion with three to play, trying to break through and win on American soil. And you know, for anybody who hasn't grown up here in the US, they know that winning in America means just that little bit more, especially on the LPGA Tour, which is basically a world tour. Slightly different in the men's game, but in the women's game, this is it. You got to get it done in the States. Now, Kupcho.
Just right at 4 feet, which is unthinkable to me when I'm looking over where that first shot came to rest, but pretty much straight.
Great up and down too, fantastic.
Did we get an
down.
Assist?
We did help out slightly.
A little bit.
Although it looked like the ball was going to be lying in a dreadful spot.
We might have actually heard it, considering how bad that lie looked.
When I heard we were having a booth hit today, that's not what I had in mind.
Jennifer Song for three. Born in Michigan, but then moved to Korea when she was a youngster. Came back to Michigan when she was in the early stages of her schooling. And this was the putt that could be all important for Mel Reid. This one misses, and she slips closer to those players chasing. But now a three-shot cushion with three to go.
And it's more than just keeping the lead. It's performing when you need to. It's having an obstacle that you just overcame, getting a bad lie and still converting. It's all of those things that give you that little mental edge. It's not just about keeping the lead.
Thinking about Tiger at the U.S. Open in 2000, he had the huge lead, and his goal was no bogeys on Sunday. And you say that's him. It wasn't because he was going to lose if he made a bogey. It was a goal he had set for himself. Kupcho first.
Another really solid drive, cutting the corner a bit as well. That's just going to be a short wedge in.
Now, Mel Reid, you may have seen her caddy, Ryan DeVoe, that there was not a lot of emotion, and he told me during the week that one of the things they talk about is not getting too high or too low. Good putt, bad putt, we move on.
This is a little bit right of Kupcho's. Should be fit solidly enough, easily into the fairway.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Ooh, right past it. There was definitely a fist bump, but then it's okay. 16th tee, right? 17.
This area around the hole is pretty flat as well today. Tough to get a sense maybe of the read. Henderson for birdie and seemed to move left early, and miscue there from Brooke. The all pars on the back nine so far for Brooke Henderson, just outside the top five. Mel Reid with a three-shot lead.
At the 16th, Nasa Hataoka.
Hasn't really been a best back nine. This one is from really long range, 18 yards worth, up a tier.
Oh, oh. Wow, yes. As she said, she has struggled with the speed of the greens.
Oh, Lord.
Didn't there. Had the lead going into the weekend by one. Birdie gets her to 13 under and breaks out of a tie for fourth. She's fourth alone. Good look at the 16th fairway, the 17th green. Mel Reid leads by three with three holes to play. She's in the fairway at the 16th. So is Kupcho. Jennifer Song, I believe, will be first. Just left.
Yeah, well, through the fairway, actually. This dog leg, not a great lie, but with today's hole location, which is just evil. I mean, it's evil. The front of the green and the back of the green are the lower tier, if that makes any sense. The middle of the green is a very raised tier. It's miniature golf-like in that regard, but it's a big enough tier where you can put it up there. Just the hardest one to get to.
A lot of tucked hole locations. Tom mentioned the 17th. Back nine playing over par.
Coming out of the rough downwind here, just the middle of that frontier would be ideal, which is about 100 yards away, 116 to the hole. Pulled a little bit, and it might have jumped some. Oh, lands right into the slope. Nice.
Perfect. And you can see just three off the right-hand side, so a popular place is just left of this hole. But you couldn't get more pin high than that.
This isn't match play, but Kupcho does have a chance to apply some pressure here to Reid.
Yeah, from 103, even though the wind is helping from the right, you can, on these softish greens, land it up there, keep it there easily. It's got to be very precise with the distance. It's a little left.
Head toward the reaction. She knew it.
Told you the whole occasion was evil.
Yeah, nearly actually hit it through the tier to the back edge and then spun it all the way back down to the front of the green.
I think she was on each tier at one point.
Almost.
Obviously, right now, if you hit it, it's the shoulder, and I think that that's perfect. See the two trees left of the hole? The split those perfect, bud.
There's no less than that, huh?
No. Shoulder's perfect.
Could easily get there with a sand wedge, but I think she's taking the gap wedge just to take some spin off it.
It's there.
It's flying plenty.
Yeah.
There it comes.
Good spot. Yep, it is. Good.
Moving one step closer to her first LPGA Tour title. Back for birdie in a moment.
This is for every girl who hears people say she won't make it, but refuses to listen. For every girl who thinks not about what she has to lose, but about what she has to gain. This is for every girl who doesn't look like everyone who's come before, but may look like those who will follow. This is for every diamond in the sky. This is for every girl.
Well, we said she has a flair for the dramatic. She needs something dramatic here. Kupcho for birdie.
17 and a half yards away from the hole. Right up that tier.
We know it can be made.
Yes.
Yeah. Even on top of the tier, it's still into uphill. That's got to go. It's really got to go.
Mm. Oh, wow.
Oh, no.
Uh-oh. This is not the drama she was hoping for. Still away.
I did not see that happening. It's not an easy putt by any stretch. but I did not see her leaving it that far short.
All right. Anne Van Dam, longest hitter on the LPGA Tour, along with Maria Fassi and Bianca Pantanainen, takes advantage of the reachable par 5 18th. And an over par round, but another step in that career building towards her first victory. Par putt now at 16 for Kupcho.
It is more difficult the further away the tier is from where you're standing to really get a judge of the speed. I think that may have been the hazard with the first putt.
Nine times out of ten, you hit this one too hard. Not the case here.
Well, she would have. I'm sure she wishes she had that the first time around.
Golf Now makes it easy to book a tee time in seconds with more than 9,000 courses. Where are you going to play next? Visit the number one place to book a tee time, golfnow.com. Mel Reid is creeping ever closer. Kupcho is going to drop at least a shot. Reid has a birdie putt in a moment on the 16th green. First, Jennifer Song has a birdie putt.
Yeah, big swinger, though, tough putt. She's looking at least 3 or 4 feet left of the hole.
Never had it on the right line, right pace. And now Mel's got an incredible opportunity. Jerry, what's she looking at?
Well, that's a tough putt. It's slippery downhill, sliding to the right. Not as much break as Jennifer Song just had, but I mean, this for a 5-shot lead. I can tell you, I know tweets are going out all throughout Europe and the UK telling people to get to the TV, expecting a heck of a finish for a young lady that they're all so proud of.
Would you be putting this defensively if you're her?
Yeah.
Well, you have to. Yeah. It can get away from you quite easily.
Yeah, you got a sense of exactly how fast that was. She hardly touched that.
So a par putt for Reid, a bogey putt coming up for Kupcho, who's her closest pursuer.
So much about golf is about, you know, the opponent is not the golf course. The opponent is really yourself. And it's about this personal journey of overcoming and discovering and figuring out how good you can get. And it's kind of moments like these where it's not a difficult putt, what Mel's facing right now, but it's situational. And it's understanding, you know, what it means, but still performing at the same time. And she's been so great at staying in the present all day. She's been in such control of her game all day. This is a really good test. And she made a great save on the last hole, trying to save another one.
Just rock solid. Mel Reid will not give an inch. Two weeks after she shot 74 with a 2-shot lead in Portland and wound up with a tie for fifth, she's going to have it a 4-shot lead heading to the 17th today here at Seaview. Kupcho for bogey. Wedge in hand from the fairway with her second shot. Missed opportunity.
Yeah, she'll be kicking herself over that shot. Especially with first to play, knowing that you can put a little bit of pressure on Mel, not able to execute that shot, and of course the mistake on the putt. Still got to focus on this little baby one.
It's the second time this week. Saw her on Thursday. Back one up that was downwind as well. So I think that caught her off guard when she played that second shot because it spun back a ton.
Mm-hmm. Three-putt bogey. Four down with two to play. You know, you're two back and you have a chance maybe with an eagle at 18. But we talked about that Sunday in Portland that didn't go Mel Reid's way. We talked to her yesterday about what she learned from that experience.
We spoke about it quite a lot last week, to be honest with you, and sometimes I get too quick, and it kind of makes me quick in my swing, so just take my time tomorrow, I think, and that's basically what we kind of took away from last week, was that I was just kind of rushing things a little bit and probably hitting shots that I wasn't quite comfortable with, and so tomorrow I'm going to take my time a little bit more, and hopefully it'll make a bit of a difference.
And it was her first time ever in that position 2 weeks ago.
Yeah, and you can learn a lot from that. But one of the other things that I gathered from the interview she did yesterday was that she's not doing anything physically different than what she's always been capable of doing. And I think there's comfort in that, and realizing all along you had the skill. This isn't a fluke week. This isn't a one-off. This is who you are. And mentally, she talked about the mental shift and how that's made all the difference.
There she is at 17.
You can just hide behind the line.
It's only 107, and Jerry, anywhere left of the flag is...
Des was very adamant about that.
Yeah, you cannot miss it right here.
It's just a sandwich, but he's making sure she does not see that flag stick in her eye. He comes in again.
See the word Acer there behind her. Pick one of those letters, I think would be a good line. To spin. Not sure if that was her best strike there, Jerry.
No, it didn't go in the bunker though. It just didn't fly like we're used to seeing with her wedges, that's for sure.
Certainly the first concerned look there from Mel Reid. Need some nerves. Trying to win for the first time, but a four-shot lead. Jennifer Song's got to be thinking birdie, eagle, finish here to have any chance.
It's 107. Might be thinking eagle, Tom. Might be thinking eagle.
Oh, is it? That was close. That was a fantastic tee shot. That's a guaranteed birdie. So it's going to take Jennifer Song to 16 under par. Let's see what Kupcho can do. She'll be thinking the same thing.
Has to be. Aggressive by nature, fighter at heart. Huh.
Wow, it just
what a pair. One more hop. One more hop, it would have gone in. Right at it. So should be two birdies there. Let's go to 18.
And Brooke Henderson to finish at 12 under.
Fooled me too.
A couple of foolers at 17 and 18 for Brooke. 17.
Jennifer Song has tapped in her birdie. Now Mel Reid chipping.
Things got a little unexpectedly more interesting than we anticipated. Not a great lie. Uphill lie in the rough.
Just came out a little soft. It's a good bit of grass behind the ball. Tendency, of course, is to get a little tentative. Want to keep the ball in front of you, between you and the hole. But that was not the shot that Mel was hoping for. You don't want a two-shot swing.
Well, just to avoid a two-shot swing, because Jennifer Song has already made the birdie to get it to six under, so it could be just a two-shot lead heading to the 72nd hole. It's going to be 16 under. But another putt of a similar length to the one she had on the previous par three for par.
Yeah, Jerry, it's on a little bit of a shelf, is it not?
It's a much tougher putt than the one at the previous par three. This is up that tiny little tier, and then just past the hole, it does slope away. And that's in the back of your mind at this point, too, because there's got to be a little bit of nerves in there, although you would never tell it looking at the way she's going about her business.
There's fooled a few players today. And it is going to be a bogey at the 17th for Mel Reid. So the lead will be two. And if you told her at the beginning of the week you'd have a two-shot lead standing on the 72nd hole, she would have taken it in a heartbeat. As she says, it is a life changer to be a winner on the LPGA, but she's got to get it through the finish line. Par 5, 18th, and as we've seen in years past, anything can happen on that hole. Kupcho, to really give herself a chance.
Par 5, 18th is playing downwind. And with Jennifer's length, she can get an iron into that green easily.
To get within two, heading to that 72nd tee. Two for Song, a two for Kupcho, and they are within two, heading to a par five. It is getting interesting here at the ShopRite LPGA Classic.
On the tee at the 18th, now just two shots back, both Jennifer's first Song.
A lot of wind helping, a little from the left. He's got enough length to get home in two from the fairway. This one's up the right.
Hole location is over on the left, front left. Now Kupcho.
This club has been nearly automatic this entire back nine right here. Hammered up the right edge.
And not going to hop in. Oh, just tried to at the last moment. Mel Reid now up two.
This club's also been very good to her all day long.
Yeah,
really good. Yep, this right center.
Missed it.
That's fading to the edge now.
Oh, unlucky.
Ooh.
Just stayed in the rough.
She missed the fairway right yesterday, took a 3-wood out of the rough, and hit an absolute laser up to the green, but it went through and into the heaviest rough, where she probably would have gotten relief had the grandstand that's normally there been there. Instead, had a terrible lie. Karen called it the worst of the week. And was only able to make par. The action heats up as the PGA Tour heads to Las Vegas. The race for the FedEx Cup continues. The Shriners Hospitals for Children Open. Coverage begins Thursday at 5 p.m. Eastern on Golf. Kevin Na defending champ, Bryson DeChambeau the year before. This is the green at 18. And we have an eagle attempt for Kelly Tan. There she is, Karen.
Yeah, and she hasn't really had her best stuff today. And she hasn't given up. She's kept trying throughout the whole course. And I think it's just, again, it's just a learning curve for a player like Kelly. And I think right now, from this angle, this range, just try and cozy it on down there as best you can. And
Walk off the golf course with your head held high and a good week.
Yeah, she put herself in position at A&A early in the week, was not able to convert. That is an excellent...
Is it in?
Oh! But she is young enough where it's taking all of these experiences and going to be able to learn from them, learn what, how her body responds, how her mind responds when she's in situations like this. I remember the first time I met her, she was a young amateur playing in the Spirit International for Team Malaysia, and she told me, she said, I want to go play on the LPGA Tour when I turn pro, and she's done just that. I know she's got bigger goals ahead of her.
Yeah. 8 under par is tied for 18th. All right, NASA taking a look. Karen, a year ago this weekend, she was winning the Japan Open, a major championship on the Japan LPGA Tour. It was her second win in the last 3 years in that major on the JLPGA, and it was contested this weekend. She couldn't make it back because she's here and getting ready for next week's KPMG Women's Open. But what a turnaround it's been the last couple of years for NASA Hataoka.
Well, I mean, just really spectacular. I think just her rookie season, everything was just a little bit too much for her to take on board. And of course, she came back as a much better player. But this week, obviously, she's not going to get her fourth win. But her game has been quite impressive in places. And I think it's one of those kind of games that this may not have been her week, but watch out for her next week.
Yeah, her momentum was stunted with the COVID break. Had such a great start to the season. And now seems to be picking up the pace once again.
Yeah, the pace has been a problem all week on the greens. If I said KPMG Women's Open, forgive me, the KPMG Women's PGA Championship. It's about 80 miles away at Arana Mink. Hannah Green will be the defending champion. And then the new event, the second drive-on championship, Reynolds Lake Oconee, about 90 miles to the east of Atlanta. Then another new event, the Pelican Women's Championship in the Tampa area, and then off to North Texas for the Volunteers of America Classic. We'll stay in the Lone Star State for the U.S. Women's Open at Champions, and then conclude the season at the CME Group Tour Championship, where Se-Young Kim last year walked off with a $1.5 million check. And she was just 18 years old when she came to the LPGA Tour in 2017, was here essentially alone. Mother was not here. Her mother has since come out and followed her around the last couple of years.
And Grant, I think the pressure, though, on her in her rookie season was immense, because Ai Miyazato was just retired. She just left the tour. Mm-hmm. And she was that next Japanese hope to play on the LPGA. And I think, I mean, we've all seen the amount of media that follows the Japanese players around. And when they're solely focused on her, I think that was very intense. But now, of course, there's a number of fabulous Japanese players playing. And I think that's kind of eased the pressure just a little bit.
Most notably, Hinako Shibuno, who's here on a sponsor's invitation. She made the cut this week. And a nice two-putt birdie for NASA. She is alone in fourth place at the moment. There is our leader, Mel Reid, trying to get it to the finish line and avoid a photo finish.
You might get a touch of left to right out of this, but I would mostly just play it down. The lie is good enough, it's going to come out flush,
right? I think so, yeah.
Yeah, as do I. And it's 65, it's going to release it. Right at that tree, that's perfect.
The green is clearing.
193 the front, not a good lie. She can dig this 6-iron out of there, though. There was a very lengthy animated discussion between the two while they were waiting for the green to clear. I thought Des might be trying to get her to lay it up and make them make eagle. This has potential.
He said great shot.
So good.
Is it ever.
Just under the circumstance, everything, whether it was a bad lie, to be able to perform, to be able to hit the shot you want.
Even two putts from there would force Song or Kupcho to make this next shot that each has. Par five.
not a good lie here either. The ball sitting in some wispy grass, which isn't a problem, but there's a huge clump right behind it. 188 front, 98 hole. Whoa. That came out low screamer.
About that doozy.
Mel just came over to check with me here and Des where the ball ended up and what the lead was. So she knows the entire situation. And when I told her 15 feet and a two-shot lead, so maybe a little relief now. Jennifer Kupcho, this ball is nearly teed up. This is a great lie, all things considered. 191 hole. Just depends on the bounce. Center of the green is the line.
She was hoping for a different kick. And she made an historic eagle in the final round of the Augusta National Women's Amateur. She needs something special here to stop Mel Reid, who's marching to her first LPGA title. Today's coverage is brought to you by ShopRite, helping you get it together, together. Volunteers of America, helping America's most vulnerable. And by Wynn Grips, the best grips in golf. So Mel Reid has two putts to win in a moment, but Jennifer Kupcho and Jennifer Song could at least make her earn it one last time. Kupcho for eagle.
Unlikely though it is, we've seen stranger things. Putter from the fringe up a pretty good 2 foot slope early. Then it gets a little quick on the backside of that. Great effort.
She's had a lot of good moments today. She had a couple missteps, the double bogey on 8, and then, of course, kind of mis-execution on 16. But you mentioned she's not been in this position, really, where she's in contention the entire day. And I think she performed well, and I think she's probably going to learn a lot from those little mistakes that you just can't afford to have on a Sunday.
Yeah, the second place finish at Evian, as we said, she birdied 3 of her last 4, which was terrific, but in terms of being in the hunt all day, playing in the final group, a good experience for Jennifer Kupcho. Now Song's third.
Squirrely little lie here. You don't often find a patch of planar rough like she has right now.
Yeah, just hard to predict how it's going to come out, needing to make sure you get enough speed to cut through the rough.
Ree, is that Song still away?
Maybe so, but Mel's got her ball down already.
It's a big putt for Song, as we remind you that Sanderson Farms Championship coverage comes your way next as we wrap things up. Song has a putt to tie Kupcho for second. First round coverage from Aronimink, Thursday at 1 o'clock Eastern, will conclude on Sunday on NBC. KPMG Women's PGA Championship. Thanks to our producer Beth Hutter and director Brian Hennessy, the entire crew. Two putts to win it.
Well, I can tell you this, based on the impressive amount of caddies and fellow players gathered around on the hill and the amount of alcohol in their hands, she's going to feel like she jumped in the lake at the A&A.
Three putts to win it, actually, after the eagle attempts had missed. So now she still has two putts.
It is going to be one of the more popular. I can't imagine a more popular one out here amongst her peers, Paige.
No, I mean, she's at a personal level, she's extremely authentic. She treats everyone with respect. She's true to who she is, and I think everybody respects that. They know what she's been through personally. They know what she's been through professionally to get to this point in her career.
Yeah.
And I think that's why it's so popular. You love watching a player put in the work and put in the time and put in the years, and then it finally pay off.
Lost her mother, Joy, in that tragic car crash back in 2012. this on with a sheepish grin as she leaves that birdie putt short. She'll be third alone, and that's huge because that will earn her a ticket to the U.S. Women's Open. Mel Reid and Jennifer Song are going to have the two spots designated this week for those finishing inside the top 10, the top two inside the top 10, and she's twice a USGA champion. She won the Pub Links and the U.S. Amateur 2009. Solo third. And one last putt. 33-year-old from Derby, England.
Yes!
Read all about it. Mel Reid is an LPGA champion for the first time.
Oh, man. Fuck yeah, buddy.
Got a few goosebumps. That's a special moment for a player who had a very disappointing Sunday 2 weeks ago in the same position.
Are you ready?
You know, I think back to a year ago, she was not selected for the Solheim Cup, but went over there as an assistant captain, as a teammate. And I think that's the humility, the humbleness that she has about the game, I think is what also makes her so, so popular amongst her peers.
All right, Jerry, you've got the champion.
We do indeed. I told you it was one of the more popular wins amongst her peers, amongst the fellow caddies. They know, and as do all fans, what she has been through. And Mel, you said yesterday it took you, go ahead, Emma. You said yesterday it took you a little longer to get here than you thought. Is it worth the wait?
It's emotional, like 100%. Yeah, I just want to call my dad, honestly. Like, just after like Portland, I just wanted to kind of redeem myself and just have felt I handled things a lot better today, obviously. And just a huge respect and thank you to Dez, my caddy. You know, he really pulled me through today. So I love the boy to death. He's kind of our new roommate. So, yeah. Thank you, bud.
What will that call with your father be like?
He's probably in the pub. He's probably not even coherent right now. Hopefully he's watching it in the Black Swan in RJ. But he's probably not coherent right now. So if he can just say a couple words, that'd be nice.
After the bogey at 17 and the four shot lead shrinking to two, the shot at 18, was that as much a relief as anything else when that six iron came out of there like that?
Yeah, it actually came out perfect. We were thinking between five and six, but we knew like being short was fine. So obviously disappointed with 17, but we didn't want to do anything stupid. It just kind of spun a little bit more than we wanted it to. So, but yeah, just relief. It's just a huge relief.
You've been a part of the crew that runs out to spray people with alcohol and water or whatever it may be. You dreamt of this moment for a long time. What does it say to you to have all these
peers? Thank you to everyone. Yeah, thank you so much, guys, for coming out. Like, it makes that moment even special, you know, and you got your mates here and just all the messages I've had over the last couple of days. Like, I do read them. I do hugely appreciate it. And just, you know, there's a lot more to it than just me. Like, I've got a whole team, friends, everything. They're kind of, my friends are like my family, so just everyone involved, everyone deserves a drink tonight.
And maybe a sponsorship from High Noon coming up. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Well, it was a little after 4 p.m. local time. But High Noon for the next few hours for Mel Reid and her friends. She moves into the top 10 in the race to the CME Glow, which is led by Danielle Kang, who will be a past champion at the KPMG Women's PGA Championship next week. Thanks to everyone who made it happen this week. For Paige McKenzie and Tom Abbott, Jerry Foltz and Karen Stupples, I'm Grant Boone. The wait was long, the road was tough and at times tragic. But Mel Reid is a champion, and you can see the joy in her eyes. So long from ShopRite.